My mother was diagnosed in late 2003. I think she definitely would have had more worry about us than herself. I don't think she's ever thought one day of her life that it would, well, it would cause her death. I think she completely knew from the start that she'd be able to beat it, and it was more about easing the pain for us and ensuring that we didn't react stupidly.
My journey's there. My mum was actually diagnosed and passed away from breast cancer just before our eldest son was born. So when Tony was diagnosed, it was very traumatic, but I've wanted to be there for her every step of the way. Just whenever I can, I take time off work or drive her to most things. She doesn't drive, so I kind of have to be there for most things. I'm the taxi driver, but I've just always wanted to be there for her. I couldn't imagine what it would be like going through it if you didn't have someone, your supposed best friend, being there to, just for a shoulder to cry on or a shoulder to lean on. Someone that you love be there for you. I couldn't imagine if the roles were reversed. I know she would be there, and I wouldn't be able to do it without her. So
yeah,
I had to be there.
So it was a bit of a shock, and it has been difficult in terms of Angus was very tired. Also probably had a quicker fuse, a bit more irritable. Then of course there's the other family members, so it was tough just worrying because there's nothing you can do about it. You just have to live through the experience, and so it did cause quite a lot of stress in the family.
Hardest time is during the chemotherapy, because I didn't recognize my wife, And when the chemotherapy was finished, I found my wife again.
It's been a journey that I went down with my mother, regrettably twice with my mother, but she's 83 years old. We had dinner with her last Tuesday, and she is in fine health.
It's as much a shock as it is, trying to work out what's going on, what it's all about. I mean, I've had a previous partner that had cancer before, so in Bronwyn's case, my previous partner passed away from it, so I've seen the reality of cancer taking someone. When Bronwyn was diagnosed, there was all the fear of that coming back, but you put all that on hold because it's more about being there and supporting the person and getting them through it. And in the same case, we've got a 12-year-old son who at the time I think he was about 9 or 10, so trying to make sure he's okay, getting the rest of the family going through it, just being there for everyone.
It's a very empty feeling, not being able to help, so if you're just there in body and soul, you're supporting your wife.
My mum was diagnosed with breast cancer in the mid-80s, which was quite a long time ago, and a lot has changed since then, and she unfortunately passed away 20 years ago. And compared to the story of my sister, who was diagnosed about 4 or 5 years ago and also unfortunately passed away 2 years ago, really didn't know much about what was going on, and particularly when her diagnosis turned into a secondary diagnosis, I didn't really understand what all that meant. And I think Mum didn't want to burden her children with the details and the scary details that were probably going through her head.
It's changed our life now in a way that we're not concerned about stuff we used to be concerned about. We're more worried about spending time with the kids. I think basic things in life that you've got to put into perspective. Being the richest bloke on the block doesn't make you any better. So now, spending more time with the family and the wife is just, really important to us. Probably made me a better person, to tell the truth. Instead of running off doing everything I wanted to do, considering that, everyone else in the family now, what everyone wants to do.
Being there to listen, it can be difficult because you may feel that you've got to come up with an answer or wise words of encouragement or whatever, and
often there are none.
To someone who had a friend or a family member with breast cancer, if they came to me and said, "Look, I don't know what to say to them, what should I say, I'm uncomfortable," I'd be saying to them, tell them that. Just go up to them and say, "Look, I don't know what to say to you, you know, but I want you to know that I care about you and I'm here for you, but I don't know what to say to you." And you know what, that's okay too, because none of us really know what to say. I think it's just letting the person know that you haven't just completely wiped them.
Who cares what your mates say? Just show up, you're there for your wife. That's all there is to it. Like, you know, your mates will call you a pussy or whatever, excuse the language, but yeah, it's an important thing and you should be there for your wife.
Men try and be a little bit of Superman anyway, but you realise in this circumstance you can't be, right? So you have to sit back after a while and just be Clark Kent. You just have to go along and be supportive for the ride, and also be careful to manage your expectations of what your partner can, or your wife or your spouse can actually do, because I think the impact can be quite severe, and she can't do as much as you expect, so you've got to lay off.
Talk to people if you can, but it's not easy. It's not easy. You just take it one step at a time.
I think that was really important for Mum, is to know that we were there getting on with life, enjoying life, and we'd be there to support her whenever she needed. Seeing Mum go through it and come through the other side, and seeing her as strong as she is today, and she has the most wonderful lease on life. I mean, she leaves us all behind. She's often working and running around and travelling and doing wonderful things, and I think that definitely rubs off on those around her.